Meine Herren, Christina.
Thank you.
Some people may ask, They had Jesus right there, and they had seen the many miracles that Jesus had done with their own eyes, but they still felt that they had not had enough faith. If you read Luke 17, verses 6, can someone read it for me?
Luke 17, verse 6. Yeah. So the Lord said, if you have faith as a mustard seed, you can say to this mulberry tree, be pulled up by the roots, and be planted in the sea, and it will obey you.
So at first, the disciples said to Jesus, increase our faith. And as you heard, Jesus didn't really give them a direct answer, but he gave them a very meaningful answer, even though sometimes it can be quite confusing to understand. He said, if you have faith as small as a mustard seed, you can say to this mulberry tree, be uprooted and planted in the sea. Now, a mustard seed is very small. You've probably seen them at home when your mom's cooking, and Jesus compares faith to something that's about that small. And that doesn't really seem like a lot of faith, and you would think that these seeds will never amount to anything. But if we hold the seeds in our hands and never plant them, the seeds will never get any bigger. Also, even though a mustard seed is small, if you look inside, it is not empty. For example, if you take a watermelon, inside it has the fruit, the seeds, and the juice. But inside a mustard seed, it only has the mustard inside and nothing else. This means that your faith must be with your whole heart and soul, and nothing else should get in between. Now, what would happen if we planted these seeds? The seeds would sprout and grow into plants that are much bigger than the seeds. A huge tree can grow from a tiny seed. If you have the tiniest amount of true faith in God, it can grow and spread out and do many amazing things. Maybe not literally move trees and mountains, but you can do things that will bring people to God and increase their faith as well. By comparing faith to a mustard seed, and saying what it could do, Jesus was trying to get his disciples to understand that it wasn't their faith that was powerful. It was what God could do with that faith, that tiny amount of true faith. God could do amazing things with their lives, and when they put their trust in him. You just have to put the seed in the soil for it to grow. So in the same way, you have to actually put your faith in God for your faith to grow. We must plant our faith in good soil, and our faith must be planted and rooted in God, and he will make our faith grow for us.
Thank you. Livingstone explored the central and southern Africa. His aim was to spread Christianity and bring trade and civilization to these regions, but his later mission was more concerned with exploration, for example, to find the source of the matter. In 1845, he married Mary Moffat, daughter of a fellow missionary. His wife died of malaria in 1862, a bitter blow, and in 1864, he was ordered home by a government unimpressed with the result of his travels. Livingstone continued his efforts to find the source of the Nile. His health had been poor for many years, and he died on 1st May 1873. His body was taken back to England and buried in Westminster.
Third question, in what spirit did Paul determine not to come to the Corinthian church again? In what spirit did Paul determine not to come to the Corinthian church again? So answer from chapter 2nd. Second Corinthian chapter 2. Chapter 3.
get ready for the next question. What does a person become who is in the Christ? What does a person become who is in Christ? Answer from the chapter 5. What showed Paul's care for Titus? What showed Paul's care for Titus? From second chapter. What showed Paul's care for Titus? Last question. What ministry focused on the incarnation? Chapter 5. What ministry focused on the incarnation? This mention on chapter 5. There is only one word. Are you ready to correct the answers?
Yes.
What is the first answer? Who was with Paul? Correct everyone? The second one? How did Paul describe God? In what way? What is the answer? The father of is mentioned on the first chapter, verse 3. The father of mercy and the God of all comfort. The two answers. The father of mercy and the God of all comfort. The third question answer. You can answer. What is that? In what spirit did Paul determine not to come to the Corinthian church again? What is that? Chapter the second, the verse first. Heaviness, or sadness, anything you can write. What? You can write either heaviness or sadness or if you don't want to, you know. That is a reference to chapters 2. The fourth question answer, anyone wrote? Fourth one?
Files. Triangle files.
What? Satan device for it's mentioned chapter 2, verse 11. You can write either Satan should not have advantages of us or Satan device or something like. And the fifth question answer is controlled. What is that? Yeah. The sixth question answer? No? Yeah, new? Something else. You need to ask for that. New? New creation. Yeah, you can have. How you can have? How you can like new? Something in the sense. Is it? Malayalam, it is Pudhiya Srishti. If somebody is writing only Pudhiya, the first person won't be able to. Okay? So you have to write the new creation. Right? What is the last answer? What showed Paul's care for Titus? What is that? Because he had no rest in his spirit until he found him. He was searching. It is mentioned on chapter 2, verse 12 and 13. He had no rest in his spirit until he found him. That was the answer. The last question answer, what is that? What ministry focused on the incarnation?
symbolizes it. The other is got a reconciliation. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Gordon, my group is for seniors, and I hope this was very beneficial. Your lovely family, Shrinichu.